2002, over Germany, the middle of the night.
What is it?
A Russian plane is taking children on holiday to Spain, but the pilots can't believe what they see heading towards them.
Get on the left!
Increase. Climb.
Climb, you said!
June 2002, the city of Ufa in western Russia. Ufa is populated by both Christians and Muslims. This year, its most outstanding teenagers have been chosen to go on a two-week vacation organized by UNESCO near Barcelona in Spain. They're among the most clever, athletic or artistic children of Ufa. Kirill Dikhtaryov is a 14-year-old prodigy. He's been painting since he was 4 years old and has already had two public exhibitions. Alina Hananova is a 12-year-old who's won several gymnastics competitions. The 46 children from Ufa, accompanied by a few teachers, leave on a train to Moscow. There, they're due to catch their flight to Barcelona. But in Moscow, things start to go wrong. The tourist agency accidentally takes the children to the wrong airport, so they miss their plane. They're terribly disappointed. While the agency tries to sort out the mess, the children go sightseeing in the Russian capital. It takes 2 days to charter another jet, but finally, they're on their way to Barcelona. On July the 1st, 2002, the children from Ufa board their plane at a Moscow airport. The Kaloyevs are not part of the school group. They're going on a holiday to meet their father, who's an architect, and is finishing a project near Barcelona. No fewer than five Russians are flying this plane. The captain is Alexander Gross, who's been a pilot for over 30 years.
Alexander had a good theoretical knowledge. He was very smart.
Today, the first officer is Oleg Grigoriev. But actually, Grigoriev is the airline's chief pilot. On this trip, he'll be evaluating Captain Gross's flying.
If you did something wrong, some captains would criticize you very rudely. Others would be very formal and polite. But Oleg Grigoriev would express his disapproval in a gesture, like that, meaning, why on earth did you do that?
Captain Gross is in command, but Captain Grigoriev is his supervisor. If it comes to the crunch, who will really be in charge? Seated in the left rear is Murat Itkyulov, normally the first officer, but who's not officially on duty because Grigoriev is in his seat. Nevertheless, since he'll soon be promoted to captain, his opinions are considered.
Murat was a professional pilot.
Murat was a very professional pilot. He loved to fly. Murat was interested in the new stuff in aviation and always kept up to date on the most progressive things brought in.
Also on the flight deck are an experienced navigator and a flight engineer. Just before 11 that evening, Bashkirian Airlines flight 2937 leaves Moscow. The plane is a Tupolev 154. Like most modern aircraft, it carries collision avoidance equipment called TCAS, or Traffic Collision Avoidance System.
Descend, descend, descend.
TCAS works because all commercial aircraft carry a transponder, which sends a constant stream of radio signals, identifying them and saying where they are. TCAS listens in and calculates whether any of the planes is on a collision course. If they are, it will tell the pilot what action to take to avoid collision.
Descend. Descend.
If air traffic control should ever let them down, TCAS will be their last line of defense.
Clear of conflict.
Hundreds of miles away in Bergamo, Italy, a Boeing 757 is getting underway. It's flying for DHL, the international freight company, and is heading for their European base at Brussels in Belgium. The Russian Tupolev will cross its path over southern Germany. The Boeing has only two people aboard, Captain Paul Phillips, who's British, and First Officer Brandt Campioni, who's Canadian, and due to fly the next leg of the journey. The DHL takes off at 6 minutes past 11 on what will be its last journey. To 8 at the SkyGuide Area Control Center in Zurich, Switzerland. The busy day shift has ended and the night shift is reporting for work. Peter Nielsen is an experienced controller. He's been doing this job for 8 years. The center regulates air traffic in southern Germany as well as northern Switzerland. Tonight, there are only two controllers on duty. But the traffic in their sector is light, and Nielsen's colleague decides to take a lengthy break, a common practice at SkyGuide. Peter Nielsen is now responsible for all air traffic on two radar screens, which sit several feet apart. At 10 past 11, two technicians arrive. They inform Peter that SkyGuide management has authorized them to carry out maintenance work on the main radar. While they do so, the screens will work much more slowly, and will give no visual two-minute warning if planes are getting too close to each other.
Tie into 933, route traffic in Allgäu. Bavarian 350, descend flight level 270.
The engineers now tell Peter Nielsen they have to shut down the telephone system as well. They switch over to the standby phones. No one realizes it yet, but the seeds of disaster have been sown. The Russian plane, filled with schoolchildren, is now over central Germany and flying towards Switzerland. Captain Grigoriev gets final clearance from the last German control center before they cross south into Switzerland.
128.05, Bravo Tango Charlie, 2937, goodbye.
The German controller hands over the Russian plane to SkyGuide, where Peter Nielsen is at the helm. Meanwhile, the DHL plane is climbing north over the Alps and is now entering Swiss airspace.
Zurich, radar, good evening. Dilmun 611, I'm climbing flight level 260, direct ABC.
Captain Paul Phillips of the DHL requests clearance to climb to a higher altitude. The thinner air there will mean less air resistance and save fuel.
Roger, climb flight level 320. Direct Tango Golf Oscar and requesting 360,
thanks, if it's available. Dilmun 611, climb flight level 360.
The DHL reaches flight level 360, or 36,000 feet, the same altitude as the Russian plane. And they're on a collision course. But they're many miles apart. So far, no danger. Now the assistant gives Peter Nielsen a new flight strip. An Airbus Aero Lloyd Flight 1135 is flying to the airport of Friedrichshafen nearby. It's going